Now, we talked earlier in this lecture about kind of the basic approaches to scaling. We said the first one was optimize the code. And when we're talking about a database, we're probably not optimizing code, but this stage of thinking means, you know, have the appropriate indexes, you know, make sure the query is sane, you know, make sure you're only querying for things that you actually need, that the query is simple, you know, those types of things. We're not going to do that here because our query is actually very simple and Google App Engine makes our indices for us. But this is always the first thing you want to check. If the index App Engine makes isn't optimal for the query you're running, you may have to make something by hand. You know, so you should always start here. You know, the first step is limit the work the database needs to do in the worst case. Let's assume we've already done that, because we have for AscuiGen. Something else we talked about was adding more machines. We don't really have control over that in this particular situation. App Engine manages that for us. If you're not using App Engine, maybe you need to add more machines. Maybe you need to start doing replication or sharding or those techniques. Now, if you've ever tried to do those techniques on your own, you know that they're very difficult. They're very complex. And this is usually adding more machines when you're talking about a database is kind of the last resort for scaling. Something else we talked about was using bigger machines. Again, we don't have a whole lot of control over that on App Engine. I think you can upgrade machines a little bit, but you know, let's say we're done messing with that, or maybe we're tired of paying for database queries and we just want to get to the fun part, what we're going to spend this lecture talking about, which is caching. A very simple thing we can do after we've optimized the database and we don't want to fiddle with more system administration is cache this query. You know, in AscuiGen, the front page of AscuiGen only changes when somebody submits. So that means it's a good opportunity to cache what we actually store. And that is what I'm going to do right now, is add a little bit of caching to AscuiGen. Okay, you all remember AscuiGen. It's online at AscuiGen.com. You remember how it works? We can type in a title, and then we can draw some ASCII art, or in my case, paste it. And when you submit the art, you see a listing of all the previous arts submitted to AscuiGen. The way this works in the code, when you do a get on AscuiGen, we call this function called renderFront, which is defined here. Okay, so this renderFront function, basically what it does is it runs this data store query written in GQL that looks up the 10 most recent pieces of art. So limit 10, that's how we know we're looking up 10. Order by created descending, so that orders them by the time they're created. This where ancestor equals art key is a data store technique for basically ensuring that your query is consistent. Kind of wanted to talk about that in unit 3, but things seem to be getting a little complex. If you read the data store docs, and kind of search for the word consistent, you'll see what this technique is referring to. So anyway, not super important for our purposes, but just so you know why that's there. It's not required. If I got rid of this at our scale, the site would behave exactly the same. So then what we do is we actually run that query. Remember, this just defines the query. When you iterate over the query, or in my case, turn it into a list, that's when you actually go to the database and get the results back. Remember, I turn it into a list here so that I don't accidentally run the query twice when I iterate over it again here, and then again when we actually render the page. I just want to run the query once. So what we want to do is cache this query, because our front page isn't going to change very often. Most users come to AscuiGen and just look at the front page. We don't need to hit the database over and over and over again every time a user does that. That's just going to, you know, cost us money, waste Google's resources, and generally just make the world a worse place. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pull out this piece of code into its own function, so it's a little bit easier to manage. OK, I'm going to call this function topArts. It's not going to take any parameters, because we're just returning. We know what the query is going to be. The query is going to be the same every time. OK, so all I've done is I created this function topArts, and I copied this code. Actually, I cut this code from renderFront and moved it into this function, and then we make the query, we run the query, and then we return the result. And then in renderFront, we just call the topArts function. So everything should behave as it did before. We can go ahead and give that a test. Here's our front page with our art, and if I were to reload this page, we see that nothing's changed. So nothing big there. We didn't expect anything to change, and nothing did. Okay, so let's go back to the code and start making our improvements. Now, one thing we're going to want to do is we want to have a way of telling ourselves when we're actually running this query so we can actually test to make sure our code is working. Now, I'm not a Google App Engine pro, but I'm going to add a little statement like this, logging.error, and we're just going to say this DB query. And this will print out in our error console the string DB query. Now, normally you should use logging.debug for this purpose, but the debug mode in App Engine is driving me nuts right now. So this will be a little bit easier for me to demonstrate. I'm going to have to also import the logging module for this to work. I'll go ahead and do that. just import logging. So this should print in the console every time we run a DB query. And let's see if that works. So here is ASCII Chan, and I'm going to hit reload on this page. And then I'm going to go to the terminal. And we can see that I'm printing error DB query. That's my string. And then we can also see that the browser fetched slash, which is the actual request to ASCII Chan, and also request favicon, which, since I haven't created it, just 404s. So now we have this printing, and we can see that every time I reload the page in the browser, we get these lines again, and I see the words DB query right before the request. What we want to do is we want to get rid of these words without just commenting out the logging statement. Okay, so let's add some caching, and we're going to use the same algorithm we used in that quiz that you guys just implemented. We're going to create a dictionary, and we're going to call it cache. Now, we have to have a key to cache. I usually like to store my keys in a variable. In this case, I'm just going to call the key top. This is how we're going to store how we're going to reference the result of this query in our cache. And then we're just going to change, then we're just going to rewrite this function to use the caching algorithm. So if key in cache, arts equals cache key. Else, we want to run our query. So we run our query in the else statement, and of course we want to store the result of our query in the cache. And then we return our arts. Okay, so pretty simple change. Now we're caching the result of this one query. Let's see if it works. We go to our browser, I hit reload. The page loads with no errors, so that's good. And then I go to my console, and I see that it printed out DB query and has the results. Now if I were to reload this page again, no error. And I go back to the console, and I can see that we made a second request. Here it is, git slash. But this time, there's no DB query. So if I were to go to our front page and hit reload, trust me that I'm doing it. You can kind of see it blinking a little bit over and over again. And then I go back to the console. We can see a bunch of requests, but no DB queries. That's pretty cool, huh? So now our front page is a lot faster. Let's submit a new piece of art to ASCII Chan here, or at least my local ASCII Chan. This is going to be a picture of beer. Looks like it's from Hofbrauhaus. And I click submit. Huh, my beer did not appear. I still have my original art from before. What do you think happened?